What's up, reefers? It's time for an update on the Peninsula and the new Red Sea Nano Max. So first, we're gonna go over a few new things on the Peninsula and some things I wanted to discuss. And then we're gonna get to today's project of putting the rock structure together for the Nano, as well as putting in some sand and filling it up with water to get the cycling process started. But first, let's get to the Peninsula update, and then we'll get started on the project of the Nano. So I got a few more SPS corals for the Peninsula from a local reefer. This one is a RC poison ivy. It's actually lost a little bit of color in the transition, but hopefully it'll settle in soon and color back up, because it was just a beautiful color in his tank. Some of his corals were just ridiculously beautiful and high end. So I'm excited to get this one settled in and growing and getting its color back. The next one is a unknown one, and right here you can't really tell much about the color. Once it grows in, it had basically multiple colors throughout. Once it grows in and gets settled in, gets its color back, I'll give you a better idea of what it looks like. It was definitely a beautiful piece. His tank was just ridiculously beautiful. I wish I would have taken a shot to show you a clip of. Next time, I think I might do that next time I go pick up some corals from him. But I'm hoping these things grow in and look as beautiful as they did in his tank, because they were just incredible. The next SPS I got from him here is Reef Raft Red Diablo. Again, the coloring, it needs to come back. Just the transition of getting it to this tank, first getting it here, dipping it, acclimating it, and getting it to the tank kind of made them lose a little bit of their color. And as well as the camera's not showing colors that well. Once this thing colors up and I can show you a better view of it, it'll be a lot prettier. And right behind it is another one, which is a pink shortcake, which is also gonna hopefully color up and look as beautiful as it did in his tank. And finally, the last SPS I got from him, which actually broke off a piece and I stuck somewhere else, but is a Diabolic Pac-Man, and it is also a beautiful coral, especially under blue light. It just glows lots of different fluorescent colors, mostly yellow with awesome tips. Again, when they grow out, I can show you a better view of how beautiful they truly are. But again, they've been in the tank a short period of time and they just need to get their colors back from the acclimation process and the dipping process. But everything's hopefully gonna settle in well and start coloring up and growing like some of my other corals. As you can see, the red dragon is actually blowing up and doubled in size and getting many new tips. Many of my other SPSs are just budding a bunch of little nubs and growing. I can't really complain. This tank is doing excellent, doing very beautiful, and I'm just excited at the level that it's just growing and just, you know, flourishing at. So hopefully it continues to go that way. I'm doing my best to keep it that way, but we'll see how it goes. And that's it for coral additions. I did have one new fish addition, this copper band butterfly. He's been in this tank now for, I want to say, a month, maybe a little longer. Doing real well, going around, getting along with everybody, eating, thankfully. These guys are a little picky, so I was really worried about him, but he was eating at the fish store, and when I got him, he didn't eat for a couple days, but then he went back to eating. So thankfully he's doing great, and hopefully he continues to do great. So that's it on the updates for the Red Sea Peninsula. What I did want to talk about is
a little bit about the CO2 reactor. So as you guys might remember from previous videos, I put a CO2 reactor on here to try to get my pH up. It did okay, but didn't do a great job. And I continued to do research because I was burning through media in a week or less, and it was pretty bad. So I ended up doing some research and found out that you need a lot more than just that little teaspoon that you put on the bottom of the reactor to make this media last longer. And some tricks some people have were running a tube from the reactor into a moist container, a container with additional like fluid in there, so it's sucking up humid air. I didn't want to do that. What I ended up actually doing was running a tube from the reactor into my top off container because it always gets humid in there and it sucks up nice moist air, and it's actually helped. I've actually had the media now last me for 2 weeks, and when I changed it earlier today, it still had some remaining media left that wasn't burnt through. So just a heads up, if you're using a CO2 reactor and you want your media to last longer, if you have a top off container, run the line in it where the top is on to keep the moisture in, the humidity in, and of course make sure the tube doesn't suck up any water, but it's actually done great. It's made my media last longer. So just a tip for you guys. Also, I ended up changing the media type I use. I stopped using the bulk reef supply media and ordered new media that I found shows a lot better coloring when it depletes, and that way you could definitely tell looking through the media when you need to change it. With the bulk reef supply one, the color changing wasn't that great, and you'd look at it and it almost looked like the same color. With this media, it definitely turns violet. Like you can't like mistake it when you burn through it. It definitely gives you a whole different color. I'll link the new media down there. It's actually even cheaper than it is at Bulk Reef Supply. If you're interested in it, it'll be in the link in the description below. So I've been using that for the past probably like 3 weeks now, and like I said, it's been on point. It's lasted, and with the tube going into the water reservoir, it's definitely lasted very long, and I've liked this performance. Anyways, that's it for me talking today. Let's get on to the project of the Nano. It's time to get some rocks into this tank and get some sand in there as well. So I think I got an idea of what I want the structure to look like. But before we get to putting the stuff into the tank, I'm just going to tell you what exactly it is. It's actually some man-made rock by Carepsy. I've actually used this same rock in my 65-gallon when I removed everything from there and put it into the peninsula. I actually got additional rock and put it into that tank to use while I was using it as a quarantine tank. And now I actually have some aggressive fish in there, including a lionfish, a trigger, and a snowflake eel. And that tank, of course, I'll go over it later, but it's just a holding tank for hopefully another project tank that will be happening later this summer, but we'll see. But for now, I've used this rock before, I like it. Heads up for people who are putting this into a currently established tank: when you first put it in, it'll make your skimmer go nuts, so heads up. You might need to, shut off the skimmer or lower the water level in the skimmer so it doesn't go berserk and spill everywhere. But The rock itself is great. It's not it's not too expensive. I'll stick a link to the Amazon page or the Amazon site where I bought it from. It was 40 pounds, was like 80 bucks, and sometimes they have a sale where it takes off like 12 bucks. You really can't ask for more. As you can see, it is colored, so you know, but that doesn't really matter because once the coralline algae builds up on it, it'll all look the same. But anyways, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna stick this in as well as some live sand from Nature's Ocean, which also has some bacteria in there, which also is gonna help with the cycling process. But first we're gonna put the rocks in and get the structure set, and then we'll start putting the sand in and filling it in with water. As you can see, the tank is looking great. The LED's in. Yeah, all the filtration is in, and I really, really am liking this setup. It's definitely a great all-in-one tank. You know, even though it's small, but it's a great entry-level tank for anyone. Anyways, enough talking. Let's get started with the structure. We'll be right back. All right, so we got the rock structure done. Not quite like I originally envisioned it, but I think it came together pretty well. Sorry, we're running on a moonlight right now and some room lights, but we should get a better view tomorrow once the two-part adhesive sets. And if everything looks good, which I think it will, we're gonna put some sand in and some water and get the cycling process started. So I will see you guys in the morning. Later. Okay, reefers, it's time to get back onto this project. Gave the rock structure a few days to let the epoxy settle, and I'm thinking it looks great and it's ready for me to start putting the sand in and start filling the tank up. So I'm gonna stick the live sand in, and I'm also gonna actually pull probably around 10 gallons of water out of my peninsula and put that in here just to have some established water in there, and put the remaining fresh mixed salt water. But right now I'm gonna dump the sand in and start bringing up buckets of water. So let's get working on that and get this thing filled and get the cycle started. All right, reefers, we got ourselves a running tank. Everything's all set up and on, except for the skimmer. I'm gonna keep that off until the bacteria gets a chance to colonize and multiply. I ended up actually putting 15 gallons of water from my peninsula and a little more fresh mixed salt water just to help the cycling out. I know I used live sand and the rock had some dried bacteria spores, but the more bacteria in there, the better. Also, to help with the cycling process, I'm actually gonna throw some Fritz Turbo Start 900 in there. Not sponsored by them, just wanted to try it out, see how it works. And last time I used a different brand when I was cycling the peninsula, but I wanted to try this out. I will not be doing what most people do, where dump this in and dump fish in. I'm just gonna dump this in, let the cycle take place, and when I think it's ready, based on testing, I'll start putting some fish in and go from there. But let's dump this in and give this tank a chance to settled in, get clear up a little bit, because there's still some residue in the water from the sand. But once it gets all nice and fresh and clean, this should look even more beautiful. All right, time to get the full cycle started. Well, now everything's in. It's just a waiting game from here before I can bring in the fish from my frag tank and show you what I got in there. You guys are aware of the two clowns, but there's another fish in there that you guys don't know about, which is only gonna be here temporarily. So this tank is way too small for that fish, especially as it gets larger. But right now, the size of that fish, I can't really stick it in the peninsula because the angels might pick on it. And that's not gonna be its final tank anyways. That fish is gonna be going into a project tank for the summer, hopefully. But I'm excited to show you that what that fish is. It's one of my favorite fish. Here's a hint, it's an angel as well. And I've been trying to get one for a while, but you know, I haven't really pulled the trigger on it, but now I actually did, and he's been doing great. So I'm excited to show you what it is when it's time to put him in here. But hope you guys are enjoying. Please like and subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and I appreciate the support. Thank you guys, and see you guys on the next video.